each other.
Directional patrol. Nowadays, the square canopy is the standard for the Australian Defence Force, and you can see why. Look at this precision.
That's a touchdown. Well done, boys. Well done.
Three, of which the Air Force has six.
Adrian, Peter, you mentioned about the Cold War. However, not just the Cold War. It's still one of the most...
Peter, on the 14th of April, show, which is half an hour before the takeoff. Get back here tomorrow.
Yeah. 3.5 tonne coming out of that aircraft, so we need to make sure that's why the bird dog's here, to make sure there's no one underneath it and that our crews are safe, and they integrate that with the ground crew.
It's a good point. You wouldn't want 13 tonnes of water coming out.
No, you would not.
And let's hope our audience is not downwind.
Let's hope not. They'll get a free shower if they are. Happy day. So the bird dog's training that, the hearse now will be on that line. He presses the button, opens the doors, and away he goes. See when the water evacuates out of that tank, it's a very distinct pattern that comes out of that. Both aircraft can indeed all about it, so they have a lot of arms doing, and we think they need to make sure that the drop pattern is right.
Forming a full afterburner maximum moment takeoff, Australia's very own FA18 Plus Classic Hornet.
Superman, with his wing while Melissa orbits around his wing suit. That's a spectacular feature for tomorrow and Sunday.
This is Peter. Rex was the youngest Australian to ever climb the Seven Peaks. He's climbed Everest. He's done many, many things. He's married to Melissa Pemberton, his wife, who was part of the...
Firework. Click. See, they got things a lot there now.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, that's genuine.
Victoria Cross for Valor. In the face of the enemy, awarded to many within the Australian Imperial Force and the New Zealand Expeditionary Force. Anzacs, raised to serve in World War I. After 8 months of horrendous